Actually, U.S. is also a market we are focused on now. Maybe in the after the July, you will see a lot of merchants will be accept WeChat Pay in U.S. Actually, now maybe in the airport and in some duty-free shops, they already accept WeChat Pay now. Actually, because U.S. is a really a big. A very big country and have a lot of merchants. We need to do it step by steps. Yeah.
So what steps are you at now? You've obviously got some of the duty free, the airports on board. So what are the next stages for your expansion into the U.S. from the cross border WeChat Pay point of view?
I think it's actually like the development in Asia countries. The first step, we will choose some merchant, which is a Chinese tourist like, just like some outlet and duty free, some famous restaurant. And maybe the next step, we will try to find some small merchant, just like some supermarket, some convenience stores, some like transportation, like taxi, like some, just like that. Yes, we will choose the big merchant, which is Chinese tourists alike. Firstly, when we have a showcase, we will try to explain it to some small merchants.
So we can expect to see more merchants
throughout
this year.
Yes.
Are you worried as you expand into the U.S. about the current tensions between the U.S. and China when it comes to trade war, that perhaps some tourists might be put off from going to the U.S. or that it could actually affect some of the American businesses' desire to bring WeChat Pay on as a partner?
Actually, WeChat Pay is just a payment product. So if the Chinese tourists want to use it and the merchant wants to accept that, I think we have market.
Hey everybody, it's Hadley Gamble from our new CNBC Middle East Bureau in Abu Dhabi. Thanks for stopping by. Now to watch more, you can try one of the videos that just popped up on your screen. And don't forget to subscribe.